Hi everyone, I want to introduce you to my new soap. This is called, I'm going to call this my pick me up soap or my wake me up soap. This is my soap made with, instead of using water this time, I used coffee, and then I took the coffee grounds and incorporated it into the soap. This time I decided to put it in a tube. Just a little PVC tube that I got from the Home Depot, Lowe's, one of those stores. And I lined it this time with just regular old parchment paper. And what you can do is sometimes it doesn't seal, it gets all over the top. So I'll use a bottle and I'll take and put it on top of the bottle and push down to pop the thing up. Let me demonstrate. Well, I don't have to do it now because I already did it. But this is my soap. I did two tubes. Oh, it's still a little warm. I guess that'll be okay. Let me move all this stuff out the way. This is my tube of soap. There you go. It's still a little warm. I used paper. And sometimes I don't use paper. I'll just go ahead and pour it in the tube, but I'll spray like a can of cooking spray in the tube and just put it in there. A lot of times it's hard to get out the tube, but it's clean. So the good way I found out of putting it in a tube without using the paper, because sometimes the paper can be a pain in the butt trying to get it out, I'll take like a Crisco can of spray, or you know, the spray and oil that's in the can. I'll pop this tube in the freezer for about 15 minutes or so. And then after I pop it in the freezer, I'll take it out for a while. And once, you know, it sets out for about a minute or two, I'll take it and put the can on the floor and sit the tube on top and push it through. And it's pretty good coming out. I usually don't use regular the parchment paper for this. I use the butcher's paper because the parchment sticks. But here's my tube of soap. Here's my small cubes that I made that they can go in little gift bags or use them as guest soaps that I've got from IKEA. Has some nice little silicone trays in a ice section. But here's my soap. I'm afraid to really cut it because it's still tacky. But let's just go ahead and cut like one piece off. And I'll do the first row. I'll just cut a little of this off. I always can use the first piece as a sample. When it cures in. There you go. So, you see the dark specks? That's coffee, not air bubbles. Let me see what it smells like. Not quite coffee yet. I can smell the coffee, but it's still got the, I guess, the lye smell to it. And I guess that'll dissipate after a while. They said the coffee would smell burnt when mixing it with the lye, but it didn't. It had a unique smell to it, almost like a deep espresso smell. It wasn't really a bad foul smelling, like some of the blogs I've saw. So let's cut this. Cut one more. And I'm gonna take these soaps and I'm gonna put it in a round. And I mixed, you really can't see the coloring, maybe after it dries. So I did, since the coffee made the soap dark brown tan, I took some of the soap out and put some brown coloring in it, soap coloring, and just swirled it in a bowl and poured it in the mold. Not swirled too much because I wanted to give it a swirly thing, but you can't really see it right now because of the soap needs to still dry and cure some more. It always baffled me how the silicone molds always make your soaps lighter than using like a wood mold or the PVC pipe mold. So this is my coffee soap. I'm going to go ahead and finish cutting this off and take some pictures once I cut it all up. Thank you. But this is my coffee soap.